In this experiment, we melt solder. What you see is an input winding with a high number of turns and a metal melt channel into which we put the solder. Let's switch the input winding to AC voltage and wait a moment. In fact, the metal heats up so much that the solder can melt. In fact, the experimental setup corresponds to a transformer. Even if the transformer has no moving parts, it can be called a machine. More precisely, a static machine. Our transformer here converts a high input voltage to a low output voltage, as you see. But how so? What you see are an input and output winding. These two windings are electrically well insulated from each other, but electromagnetically coupled by a soft iron core. We will explain it later in detail. By the way, this soft iron core consists of a pack of laminated steel, which is electrically insulated. Why so? The problem is that a voltage is also induced with the iron core, leading to eddy currents. These eddy currents cause heat and power losses. So you have to interrupt the path of eddy currents, and that's the way to do so. But how can one draw from the output winding voltage as soon as the input winding is connected to AC voltage? These two windings are not electrically connected to each other. The answer is they are magnetically coupled. Let's explain. For better understanding, let's consider just the primary coil. As soon as we connect this coil to DC voltage, a current flows through the coil and causes a static magnetic field. The direction of the magnetic lines can be, by the way, determined by the right-hand rule. But with this static magnetic field, we cannot get to an electromagnetic induction. We need AC voltage to get to an alternating magnetic field. This alternating electromagnetic field can induce an alternating voltage in the secondary coil. But for this, the secondary coil must be electromagnetically coupled to the primary winding. And this is where the soft iron core comes into play. The soft iron core conducts the magnetic field lines very well. Since the same magnetic flux is passing through the primary and secondary windings, the electromagnetic force, in short EMF, created in the primary winding is the same as in the secondary winding. This EMF induces an individual voltage in each turn. Since the EMF is the same in both coils, the voltages per turn are also the same. The output voltage must be the sum of the individual voltages per turn. Furthermore, the voltages and numbers of turns of the primary and secondary winding relate to each other as shown. And you can build a transformer with an output voltage smaller or bigger than the input voltage, depending on the ratio of the number of windings. Here, the terms step down and step up transformer are used. So far, we have discussed the magnetic flux in depth. Of course, we don't see it, but we can prove that it exists. As soon as we connect the input winding to voltage, a magnetic flux is built within the soft iron core, as we already know. And now we see that this magnetic flux is strong enough to keep the iron core together and to hold the whole weight of the transformer. When a load is connected, the output voltage can and will drop. How much it drops depends on the load, meaning the output current and how the transformer is designed. Of course, like any machine, a real transformer also has power losses. A real transformer has leakage flux, which means the part of magnetic flux that does not get linked with the secondary winding. Also, we mentioned the hysteresis loss, power loss due to eddy currents and wire resistance. But for better understanding, we see our transformer as an ideal transformer. That means with no losses and 100% efficiency. However, the output power is equal to the input power, and we can derive the following equations for an ideal transformer. We should mention at this point that the secondary winding of a step-down transformer has a bigger wire diameter than the primary winding, because you need low wire resistance to the high current you can get at the output. And vice versa, of course, a small diameter for the secondary winding when you have a step-up transformer. Going back to our first experiment where we melt solder, now we are able to explain it. The metal melt channel can be compared to a secondary winding with just one winding, which is, by the way, short-circuited. The voltage drop must be, therefore, very small. But, as we have a certain input voltage and power, we must get a high output current. Imagine high current floating through metal. It heats up, and this is what we get here. By the way, this is the way induction melting works. Now you have a much better idea about the principle of electric transformers. More information about transformers and electrics in general can be accessed on our webpage. If you want to be updated about new videos, please subscribe to our channel.